There is optimism in the energy sector as oil prices are rebounding, which could prove to be a windfall for the province and our struggling economy coming out of this pandemic. Gary Marr, CEO of the Canada West Foundation, joins me to talk about this boom. Gary, is it actually fair to call it a boom? Because we have been told in the past that it likely wouldn't happen again.
Well, first of all, it's true that we haven't seen oil prices rise this quickly since 2008, but I think it would be premature to call this a boom. A boom would suggest that you're going to be creating a great number of jobs as a result of the rise in price. That hasn't happened and may not happen for some time to come. What we're seeing is that more money as a result of the price of oil going up will result in the Alberta government being able to pay down more of its deficit. So instead of an $18 or $20 billion deficit budget, maybe it'll be $10 or $12 billion instead. But the money that producers are getting is not being plowed into drilling new wells and creating more jobs in the upstream services business. What it is being used is to pay down their own debt. Banks are compelling them to do so. And so it's very premature to call this a boom at all.
Will this last? Do you have any forecast into whether this is really short term, these oil prices for this year, next year? How can companies and the government really plan around what they're seeing?
Well, I think what the provincial government has done has been pretty prudent. They've forecast fairly conservatively on what the future prices might be. I think that's a prudent thing to do. We know that, you know, prices will at some point, for some unforeseen reason, you know, drop in the future. We don't know when, so that's why it's prudent to budget, you know, for a lower price. So I think that, you know, companies are doing the same thing. They're still taking a wait and see attitude and managing their balance sheets before they go forward on spending sprees to develop new production in fields.
So there you kind of hint at it, that they're spending this money a little bit differently. Where do you think would be wise for them to spend it if they were to invest or maybe change focus?
I think there's been a series of announcements made over the last couple of weeks that suggest that both the government and industry have turned a corner. It's early days, but the announcements about a $1.3 billion hydrogen plant in the Edmonton area, the CCUS projects, the carbon hub system, a new pipeline being proposed for moving CO2 so that it can be sequestered in various places in the province, the commitment by the five major oil sands producers that represent some, you know, 90% of oil sands production going to a net zero type of a commitment by 2050. I think that these are all ways of that in the long run will allow us to continue to produce oil and gas, but do so in a way that meets our ESG commitments. And this is what banks and this is what, you know, the investment communities around the world are looking for. So this is a very positive thing that can result in a more sustainable and more resilient industry here in the province of Alberta. That will create jobs.
Thanks for your time. Gary Marr from the Canada West Foundation.